Hey, Kenji's really strange lately, huh?
Who, Professor Kenji?
Yeah, he starts singing all of a sudden in the middle of class. He goes on about some kind of fourth dimension.
And on the last full moon, he was doing some kind of bizarre dance in the schoolyard.
That's not all. You know, they say he can hear the voices of ghosts.
Really?
It's true, I tell you. Under the cedar tree in the temple, he can hear the voice of a girl's ghost.
Be quiet. It's study time when our teacher's not here.
Shut up, you geek.
Sorry for being late. It's so nice and warm outside. The marigolds and I were enjoying a sun bath. Time just slipped on by. Spring is finally here.
Meow.
Everyone, do you understand why we can all feel warmth?
Warmth? What?
What are you talking about?
Warmth?
Warmth?
No idea. Do you know?
No clue.
You can close your textbook. So, let's all close our eyes, too.
Close our eyes?
That's right. Go ahead, everyone.
Okay. Right. Sure. Yeah.
Okay.
Even with your eyes closed, you can feel it, can't you? The warmth of the spring sunshine, the breeze blowing in like a song, filling up your body. Your body is a collection of tiny, tiny molecules you cannot see. Hydrogen, oxygen, carbon, air, wind, water, marigold petals. They're all made up of molecules just like us. And even when we're still, molecules are racing around inside our bodies. Guess how many times hydrogen molecules smash into each other every second? 10 billion times. 10 billion times. In one small second, they collide over 10 billion times. This wild and chaotic molecular movement generates heat and temperature. When you're enjoying yourself, getting excited, thinking of that special someone, don't you feel the warmth inside? It's because your heart stirs up your body's molecules, creating heat. So the human body is truly a bunch of molecules having a wild party.
A party? Huh? Hey!
Oh, hey, isn't that Miyazawa's oldest boy?
How'd he ever get to be a teacher?
Seriously, I think Kenji's lost it.
Yeah, what's up with jumping out the window? The door was fine.
Yeah, and a bunch of molecules having a wild party? Come on!
What a weirdo.
Whoa!
What's he got?
Oh. Shh! I feel it. Suddenly gone.
Oh, what? What?
Hey, stop. Hey, stop.
What do you think this looks like?
What do you mean? It's just a rock.
That's right. But what else?
Huh?
Doesn't it look like someone's face?
A face?
Well, this rock is limestone. It's smooth and pretty. Just like a movie actress. This one is quartz. It feels rough and looks stubborn, just like our school principal.
That's true.
Hey!
This one looks just like you.
This one's Ken.
Here's June.
There are all kinds of rocks.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
If you think about it, rocks and people aren't so different.
Yeah, sure.
Okay, so let's try and talk to him.
There's no way.
Stones can't talk.
The teacher's really weird.
Hey. Hey, look, he's got a hammer.
Here, listen carefully. When you tap on rocks like this, you can hear the different voices. That's the rocks, the Earth's voice speaking.
As far as one can see, the sweet smell of grass A fresh breeze washes away the grime. The world is overflowing with light. Standing here in this place, I feel the wonder of Mother Nature. Let's go.
Okay. Wow. Side by side, red, arm in arm, telegraph poles.
More poetry?
Yep. The stunning images here are so inspiring.
Oh.
Wow.
Whoa.
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 You know, someday, I'm going to build a country paradise. We'll have plays and festivals, spend our lives creating art. What's your dream?
My dream? Mine is to uncover the truth of the life force pulsating through our world and to follow that path.
That's a wonderful dream. But how will you find that path?
Well, I'm still not really sure.
Don't worry. Someday, I know you'll find it.
You really think so?
Uh-huh. You know, Kenji, I hope we can walk it together.
Me too.
Wow.
Wow.
Look, a dinosaur.
Huh?
Over there. In the amber sky. Creature from the Jurassic era.
That's impossible.
Isn't there something you can do? If I don't buy bullets for my rifle, how can I make it through the winter?
Yes, but this is just an axe and some old clothes.
It's not much, I know, but this is all that we have left. My mother is sick and she needs medicine.
62 at the most. I really can't let you borrow any more.
I'll have to take it.
Kenji! So you spent the night wandering around again, collecting junk. How about helping out the family business a little?
Why? Why can't you lend him more? He really needs the help.
Our family won't survive if we lend money out of sympathy, and the economy would come to a halt.
Sure, but why that business?
Then what kind of business would you be in?
Well, I'll sell modern art.
You're naive. Who'd buy it here in the country?
How about if I go to America and do business?
Such big dreams. Where would you get the money?
Well, I'll start making costume jewelry. How about that? I'll craft beautiful synthetic gems, work hard half the month, and write fairy tales during the rest.
Nothing but fantasies. Your stories make no sense. No one would read them. And I suppose you will actually tell customers these gems are synthetic?
Why shouldn't I tell the truth? I'll use a legitimate scientific process.
What science? How long will you keep on dreaming?
It's not a dream.
Yes, it is.
No, it's not.
I've been too soft with you. You've got to learn to live with both feet on the ground.
Huh?
Oh. The stone's warm. Because you showed it such tender care, your kind heart has warmed it up.
Toshi, you're back home.
Yes, I came back on the 8 o'clock train from Ueno. I see you haven't lost your passion for rocks.
Yep, yesterday I went all the way to Nametoko Mountain.
That far?
Here, look at this stone closely in the light.
Oh, it's beautiful.
This stone sparkles when you crack it open. That's crystallized black mica. Ages and ages ago, this stone was made up of gases from the Milky Way, where everything was pitch black. When they see the deep blue sky of our world, these little guys inside get so excited and surprised, they sparkle with wonder and joy. Bravo.
That's hymn 391. I learned it at a club at my college.
Really? What else did you learn?
Lots of things. Come on, open it.
Okay. Wow. It's real Sheffield silver. These aren't cheap.
Soon, I'm going to make you a special cake.
All right.
I learned how to bake it from an assistant of Tagore, you know, the poet, when he came to Japan.
Really? I can't wait.
You've kept writing, haven't you?
Yeah. Did you read the poem Azalea I sent you?
Of course. Say, in that poem, side by side, red, arm in arm, telegraph poles. That was about you and Kanai, right?
Huh? Don't say that.
I got you.
But Kanai is so cool. Unlike me, that guy really knows where he's headed and how to get there. You and he are the only two that understand me.
Ooh, you're like two lovers.
What? Wait a sec.
You're upset.
Stop it. You know, I get the feeling I could walk on forever with him. On and on. Forever. Till the end. Toshi! lost for direction, I left my family's home in the country and escaped to Tokyo. It's already been 6 months. I've been working at a small publishing house. I write, and keep on writing. Next Sunday, if it's convenient for you, I'd like to meet you at the Wayno Library. It's been 3 years. Let's talk into the night about literature, theater, and how we'll walk the true path together till the end.
Wow.
Kanai, it's me, Kenji. It's great to see you.
Kenji?
Yes?
That path we spoke of, we cannot walk it together.
What?
Toshi, is she all right?
Oh, Kenji! Kenji!
Toshi!
You're early. Oh, my.
What?
Your shoes! Your shoes!
Oops.
No shoes inside the house.
Hey, give me a break. This is Western style. You're okay if you can laugh that much.
Me? Ah.
Instead of settling down, I wrote a lot.
You wrote this much?
There's so much I wanted to write. My hand would just go. The letters would jump off the page and salute me.
Oh, that's just like you.
Toshi! I'll get a light.
Kenji, I don't want to die yet. I want to keep teaching at school. To fall in love. How embarrassing. I'm talking nonsense.
Don't be embarrassed. You'll experience it all. Falling in love, everything.
Stop it. Kenji? Tell me a story. One of the stories you've written. Read one to me.
Okay. While we may not be blessed with all the candy we want, we can eat the fresh, clear breeze and drink the beautiful, peach-colored rays of morning sun. In the forest or fields, I have often seen torn, ragged clothes become the finest velvet, wool, or diamond-studded dresses. These types of beautiful foods and clothes are my favorites. Gifts from the rainbows and moonlight. My stories were written amongst forests, fields, and railroads, walking through the oak forest in the blue twilight, trembling in the mountain breeze of November. This emotion overwhelms my entire being. Feeling the absolute reality of these stories,
I wrote them exactly as they seemed.
Nobody read your book. How much do you think it cost to print all these?
Please forgive me.
You need to go to the bookstore and find out what kind of books sell.
But I don't write to sell books.
Then help out with the family business. I take that back. If I left the business to you, we'd go broke in an instant. Continue with your teaching. And devote your energies to that.
Oh,
I am as a phenomenon, one hypothetical blue light, an organic
the scenery
electrical
and
torch,
all the pieces
alternating
together
current.
Intensely flickering.
Hey, it's a phenomenon.
I don't get any of this.
What's all this stuff mean?
Compound translucent ghosts?
Professor?
Yes?
I don't get it.
I know there are parts that are difficult to understand. But there are parts that are difficult even for me to understand. Why not? Why can't we search together?
If there really is some life force driving this world, why do people fight? Why do living beings kill each other? Even eat each other?
Well, such may be the will of the life force. No, we can search together for the answers we need to find.
So naive, as if you are walking upon the clouds of idealism.
You guys.
Professor, are you sick?
I'm okay, but why have you all gathered here?
We found out who the thief is.
Thief?
Yeah, my cap was stolen.
And a light bulb from the dorm is gone.
Nate got him. He saw Taka stealing at school late at night.
Till the end.
What?
Till the end, let's walk onward.
What? What? Walk onward till the end?
You're gonna punish me. Let's get it over with.
Till the end, you didn't run away. Out of the billions of people living on this earth, the fact that you and I became teacher and student is one of the mysterious wonders called fate. Right? We could have well been father and son, or even brothers. Indeed, from now on, let's become brothers. We'll be true brothers. By the way, what makes you steal from other people? If you want money or if you want things, I'll give them to you. As your older brother, I'll give you anything. My monthly salary is only 90 yen, but if you need it, I'll give it all to you. If that's not enough, you just tell me. And even if I have to borrow, I'll get it for you. So, my younger brother, tell me what your dreams are. What will you do after graduating?
Me? I want to go work in the city. Get a job at some government office or a bank.
Won't you continue your family's farm?
You can't make any money farming. I have to earn more. Earn money and... Professor! I mean, brother. I want to help my mom and my dad to live happily without any more pain.
Thank you.
Did you hear? Rumor says Professor Kenji quit school.
Seriously?
Yeah, someone heard them talking in the teacher's office.
But why?
I don't know.
Because you guys are such troublemakers.
Say what?
Say what?
But if he quits, school won't be any fun at all.
Yeah, bummer.
Oh, it's him. There, in the schoolyard.
Professor!
You'll find me down in the fields.
Amateur.
It's just the hobby of a spoiled rich boy.
You'll soon get tired and quit anyway.
New age lies in the world's ability to become one conscious and being. Understand?
They're always partying all night.
They say that's art. Mamas don't need that. We ain't people of leisure.
Think farmers can eat on flowers?
This is very tasty.
Go home.
But why? Mom went to all this trouble.
I will not eat better than those who live here.
But Kenji, you've gotten so thin. I'm so scared you'll end up weak and sick like Toshi.
Go home.
So he can trick us.
Those fertilizers he sold us didn't work.
And he says he'll pay us all back.
He's just mocking us, greedy, just like his dad.
He thinks everything can be settled with money. That's what he thinks.
Professor?
Oh, it's you guys.
Go, Taka.
All
right.
Whoa.
I went into town for more fertilizer. When I got back...
Shoot! It must be the people downstream.
I'd like to go beat them up, but I don't have the guts. Instead, putting up these markers will symbolize my feelings. I don't know. It doesn't make any sense. You work diligently at the soil. You carefully grow the vegetables. Then we eat them. We steal the vegetables' lives. Is it any different than anything else? By the way, Tetsuo, it's just you today?
Taka had to. He had to take a job in Tokyo. His father got sick and collapsed. He can't pay back the family debts by farming. He felt he couldn't show his face in front of you.
Hey, good morning. Sorry you had to stay overnight studying again. Ah, what a beautiful morning.
Professor, let's give up. No matter how long we keep at it, no matter how hard you try, nothing will change. What is this?
It's tea. I tried using pine needles to make it.
Professor, you really are weird. While we may not be blessed with all the candy we want, we can eat the fresh, clear breeze and drink the beautiful peach-colored rays of morning sun.
Farm work is really grueling. That's why we should at least try to enjoy it.
Professor.
couldn't even make it as a simple farmhand.
My body's heavy. I'm sinking to the bottom of the earth. I wanted to help the farmers, to become the god that brings rain. Important, but no human is a god. Deep in my heart, I truly believed that something good would come out of it. I'm hallucinating again. Is this the end for me? Then a pitch black cloud that clings to the ground. Within a pitch black cloud that clings to the ground. Is it impossible? Am I unable to move that huge, dark thing? Is it all for naught? Here, I brought it.
So cold. So cold, yet so warm. Kenji, because you got it for me, this snow so cold yet warm.
Toshi.
Yet, wow.
Toshi. Copernicus of the New Age, take this unbearable weight of gravity and liberate this galaxy!
Search for true happiness.
I'll give it one more try.
Whoa!
A meteorite? A stone from another world? Of course not. Spring's almost here. Provoked by anger's bitterness and immaturity, beneath the golden April sky, I spit, gnash, and pace. I am chaos.